Celiac disease is believed to have a genetic underpinning, so not everyone gets celiac disease. Patients have risk genes found in as many as 40% of the population. But it turns out that only 1% of the people actually develop celiac. So you take thousands, tens of thousands of patients, and you take thousands of normal individuals, and you just sequence their genomes. What kind of changes in the genome sequence more likely shows up in the patient than in the normals? And what you find is that some of those things, some of those changes that you observe are located within protein coding regions. And people always study them because they're easier to study. But vast majority that are found are in non-coding regions. And people have ignored, and researchers have ignored those because they're harder to study. These are molecules, RNA molecules, that do not produce protein. We found this long non-coding RNA that appears to represent an important risk gene that contributes to the development of celiac disease.